2005 in the city of Richmond, Virginia. Two marketing firms have collaborated to bring adult nightlife entertainment to the next level. Street Rap Promotions and Militant Mindz Entertainment. This is their story.
Yeah. Who run it?
You know they acting like it down now.
We run it.
You know but you acting like it down now.
Who run it?
You know they acting like it down now.
We run it.
You know but you acting like it down now. You know they acting like it down now. I tear the club off, fuck yo. This flow is gon' bring more dough.
Hollywood movies, you know, came out of Jamaica, Kingston, Jamaica, 96, went all the way to Brooklyn, came to VA, fell in love with VA. They said Virginia's for lovers, and I kind of fell in love with it myself, so I won't leave it. Crazy opportunity in VA. Saw a need for like higher level nightlife entertainment. More prestige, more classy nightlife entertainment in the Richmond Metro. So definitely try to take advantage of it.
I might just be getting nicer. You can afford to stay right. Young enough to know the right call to buy. You ain't grown enough not to put dreams. Yeah, I'm gonna get my ass out of here. Yeah, I'm gonna get my ass out of here. Yeah, I'm
Street Rap Promotion, been in the music business for like 20 years. Word up, started out with Big Daddy Kane doing, you know, a lot of things. So, you know, 20 years in the music business, man. Word up. I use, you know, my political powers that's in the music business to, you know, kind of do parties in the entertainment, like getting favors from artists that's coming to town, getting favors from record companies, trying, you know, finagle different promo artists that's coming in there. And basically, you know, it's all hand in hand. It all plays a part on both, you know, both things.
Militant Mindz Entertainment came on the scene in April 2005, trying to do something a little bit different, a little bit more classy. Somewhere you can go, feel comfortable, drink, relax, lounge. You know what I mean? Really feel like you can really court a lady somewhere here rather than watching over your back, make sure somebody's not really coming at your neck for obviously no reason whatsoever.
Street Rat is basically a marketing company, a street promotion company. It's I used to make crazy money in the record company, and now I had to, you know, suffice that, you know, record company is losing a lot of money, so I kind of like had to balance myself out and do parties and do different things, man, because record company is not making money like they used to 10, 15 years ago. So I kind of used that, the club life, to kind of balance things out.
If you ain't from VA, then you don't fucking know.
When I first met Maurice, I seen a lot of, you know, I was kind of like burnt out from doing parties and doing different things. And this cat had mad energy, man. He had mad energy. And I seen him like me a long time ago. And, you know, your mind, his arrogance and his, you know, he do things. He, you know, he don't chuck and jive. You know, I seen a lot of me and him. And I was like, yo, you know what? I was sitting like, yo, dog, this cat got that energy that I'm missing. And, you know, I need to really put him down on my team, man. Word up, because he got mad energy.
He really had all of the key aspects to make the ideas that I had in my mind materialize. You know, he had his hands into the record companies, he had his hands into the club, he had his hands into the radio stations. The ideas and the plans that I had on paper were more easy to come to life with him putting the manpower behind it to really bring everything forward, to really make the blueprint happen. It's almost like drawing up a building and watching a skyscraper reach the heavens.
Also, I bring, you know, like a little street element, and you know, he got the college background. You know, we kind of blend two worlds together and make it a hot party.
A lot of promoters out here, they rent clubs, they book artists, and they charge you $100 to get in, they charge you $70 to get in. And it's really about the longevity. I know if I paid $100 to go to a club, as much as I may enjoy myself, it's not somewhere I want to go. Rather than the promoter that's really looking out for me, that's going to tell me it's free before 11 and $5 after.
And you know, staying consistent in the longevity of it, you don't think about the money, you think about your people. You know, we being here hours before the people, helping clean them up, helping getting the feel right, so when they come here, they, you know, they comfortable. And that's a real, you know, major factor.
You know? Everybody sing the breakdown right here!
Events that we brought to Richmond that we executed, we brought some phenomenal artists through the market. You know, we kicked off the year with Neo for Martin Luther King Weekend. That was a really, really good event. We brought Young Dro when he was coming through in his first single, Shoulder Lean. That was an incredible event. You know, we took part with the Joel Santana, Jim Jones, Trey Songz, Mystical concert at the Siegel Center. You know, we had a key part in T.I. Young Jock concert at the Siegel Center as well. So, you know, all in all, the year was a pretty successful year. We kind of took nightlife entertainment to another level and continue to make strides towards improvement in the city to really captivate this market that we're really trying to grab a hold of, really let people know Richmond is for you. You don't need to go anywhere else for nightlife entertainment because we have what you need right here.
Take things up to a whole nother level, man, that they ain't seen yet, man.
Yeah. 07 is, I mean, I told him 06 is going to be crazy, man, but 07 is going to be bananas. And I'm for my word. 07 is going to be bananas.
Man, that's a promise, man. Word up.